Howdy, everybody. It's old Shug here, and today I'm going to talk to you about my hiking poles. Yes, sirree. And I'm going to show you today my hiking poles that I have been using probably for 10 or 12 years. Now I'm only talking about these because they're the only pair I own that I've ever bought. Up to that point, I always used just sticks for walking along, or started out with one when I was a lot younger, and as I got older one time I used two sticks on the trail. Then I decided to go out and buy myself proper hiking poles after hiking with a few people that had them. Now they serve a lot of purposes. Balance on the trail, you can push yourself along with them on the flats. One other thing, if I ever come to an area that's got a long flat and I'm losing traction in the day and falling behind, I will extend these a little bit higher than I would normally have them, maybe even higher than that, but a good, you know, 4 to 6 inches higher than usual. And what they help me do is sort of like Nordic, they push me along as I walk, so I'm pushing as I walk. Poles are more behind me and I can really speed myself up, but that's a really nice technique with the hiking poles. Now normally these hiking poles, and I find that most people like them, have a strap that hangs right there that you weave your hand through like a ski pole and you're locked in. I for one care less for that, because like I said, when I'm going up hills, really steep little short climbs, I like to shift my hand down quickly and I have to take my hand out of that loop. So I can just shift down, shift up, shift down, shift down, shift up. I use them with my tarp to set up in porch mode. I use them while setting up my hammock. If I need to push my suspension a little higher, I'll just extend them and I can get up the tree. You could use it as a fishing rod. It could be a weapon in many cases. You know, if you needed to whoop somebody, always strike for the hand holding the object. Now another reason I keep my straps off of mine, I can throw them down quickly when I want to take a break. Or let's say you were somebody that was getting on my nerves and threatening me out there. I got them like this. I can whip one at you. As I come in and get ready to defend myself, freedom! I'll tell you what, I'm gonna wind it up. Mainly though, I probably find them the most handy going downhill. I put my hand on top on a real steep downhills and use them mainly for balance. Though they help me climbing up, I find for me, a 57-year-old man, that they help with my balance more than anything. Mine are the Black Diamond Flick Locks. Flick lock is this little portion right here. You flick it open and slide your pole and then flick it back down. But you simply just do that, slide it out, flick it, and it's tight. I gotta say one thing, these Black Diamonds have never ever slipped on me. They've always held. I keep a little compass on mine, so as I'm walking along I can look down, get my bearing. I've got some magic ginger feathers on there. They do magical things for me in the woods. They protect my animal spirit while I'm out in the woods. Also, Hickory gave me this idea. A little bit of reflective tape right there. So if I'm at a group hang or something and I got my hammock back in the woods, and I'll have those stuck back in the woods, as I got my flashlight going back, these little tapes, I got a red one on the one I'm using to hold the camera right now, they'll glow in the dark and I can find my way back to my hammock and my tarp. Another thing I like about these is I can take them apart once again and entertain myself sitting around on the trail. And for all the backpacking I've done, and as many times as I've used these, and I use them winter and spring and summer and fall, never broken one. Never broken one. And I've fallen on these things. They've gotten stuck in rocks. I've never broken one of these. Now I use these poles in the winter as well by using the little basket that you can buy extra. And what that does, screws right to the bottom of your pole, and bought this at REI. And there you have a basket for snow hiking. And you don't have to use a different kind of pole. So this is the same pole I use for my winter hiking using snowshoes or the pulk. Now very often I use the hiking pole as a monopod for my camera while shooting back in the wild. And that's my Canon ELF 110 HS digital camera that I use for most of my footage. And I just use an ultra pod right there that'll Velcro on. La-da-da. Okay, we got a nice steep little hill right here that I'm gonna go up and down and try to film the pole technique as I go up and down. It's just my technique. I mean, it's like everything. There's a science to everything, and if you walk with hiking poles enough, you'll find that your body just starts to find a way to use them efficiently. So we'll head up that big hill now. And I can feel my hands automatically choking down on the poles. Now, a hill of this steepness, I'm using the pole, I'm digging it in, pushing and pulling. Sometimes I like to go both poles at once and shove my body forward. Okay, here we are using that technique of placing both poles in front of myself and pulling myself up that hill. Okay, now we'll descend the hill, and you can see my hands are on top of them, and I kind of have them out in front of me for balance as I take those next steps, which I find is handy when you're an old guy. Whether rocks or roots or sand like this one, they just help me with my footing. So I'm also using the pole right now with my camera on it to talk to you and wrap this up. So the only poles I've ever used are these Black Diamond Flick Locks. You asked, I'm telling you. I don't even know how to hike without them anymore. It just feels weird without them in my hands. They help my balance, they help me get uphill, they help me get downhill. They feel like protection. I use them with the camera. But after every trip I do, I always think about gear that served me so well. And these hiking poles are one of them. My boots, my hammock, that just every time go without saying. This is Shug signing off right here from the woods of Minnesota, all secure in Sector 7.